Sound design.
All right, the last step in my audio analyzer verification checklist is the EQ test. And this is just to make sure that when I manipulate my system EQ, that I see those changes represented in my measurement in my audio analyzer. So I've already taken a measurement and I saved the trace. So now if I make any changes to the EQ, I should see those represented here. So let's start up the signal generator. Okay, and now if I make a change here and I stop talking, okay, great. So the EQ test has passed. If it didn't pass, then we would see something different and we would see no change here whatsoever. So let's break this and see that happen. So I'll reset the EQ. I'll go over to my routing. I'll switch my measurement loop tap to, post EQ. There we go. Okay, so same measurement, but this time, if I manipulate the EQ, I can hear it in the room, but I don't see the change on my measurement. Okay, and that's because I have it tapped at the wrong place. So I'll leave this EQ in and I'll fix that problem. There we go. Now I can see that EQ change. Okay, and that's how you verify your audio analyzer before you do anything with it so that you make sure that you can actually trust the data. Now in the next videos, I'm going to talk a little bit more about exactly how loud does the signal generator need to be in the room. Do you need to be blasting all of your friends and colleagues while they're working as well? Or can it be at a quiet whisper or someplace in between? So I'll see you in the next video.
Sound design.